In this video, I will talk about series circuit. So what is series circuit? The DC circuit in which the resistances are connected in end-to-end connection so that there is only one path to current flow. That circuit is known as DC series circuit. Let's say I have total three resistors here, R1, R2 and R3. If one end of this R1 is connected to one end of R2 and there is no other element connected at this terminal, and if I make another connection that one end of this R2 is connected with one end of this R3 and there is no other element connected at this terminal, then I can say the resistors R1, R2 and R3 are connected in end to end connection. That means they are connected in series. Only one end of a resistor is connected to an end of another resistor. Now if I have a voltage source here, this is its positive terminal and this is its negative terminal. Now if I connect this voltage source with this series circuit, you will see I will get a current flow from this positive terminal towards this negative terminal. Let's say that current is I. Now see, this current will be flowing through this total path, and you will see in the circuit we will have only one path for the current flow. As I have current flow in this circuit, now I can calculate the voltage drop across this R1. That will be V1. It is the amount of work that is required to bring an electron from this terminal to this terminal. The voltage drop across this R2 will be V2, and the voltage drop across this R3 will be V3. Now how do we calculate V1? By using simple Ohm's law. See, if I want to calculate the voltage drop across this R1, I will take the current flow through this R1 and the value of this R1. So the current that is flowing through this R1 is I and the value of resistor is R1. Similarly, I can calculate V2. Current is I and the resistor is R2. Similarly, I can calculate V3. Current is I and the resistor is R3. Here you will see I am supplying this circuit with a voltage source of V, and R1, R2 and R3 are absorbing voltages V1, V2 and V3 respectively. Therefore, I can write supplied voltage will be equal to sum of voltage absorbed V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now, I can write it like this. V equal to V1 is IR1. V2 is IR2. And V3 is IR3. Now, you will see this I is common in all the three terms, therefore I can take it out. So I can write it like this: R1 plus R2 plus R3 into I. Now if I take this I in the left side, I will get V divided by I equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now what is this V by I? See, if I consider this as our terminal A and this as terminal B, the V by I ratio will indicate the total resistance or equivalent resistance RS from this terminal to this terminal. So RS will be total resistance or equivalent resistance. So I can write the total resistance from this A to B terminal, RS will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. The total or equivalent resistance between this A and B terminal, RS. What does it mean? Means that I can replace the sum of the three resistors with a single resistor, and the value of that resistor will be equal to RS, and this is called equivalent resistance. That means the total resistance with between these two terminals can be replaced by a single resistance. That is known as equivalent resistance. See, I have replaced the three resistances with a single resistance of RS. and you will see R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This implies when a number of resistances are connected in series. When a number of resistances are connected in series, the total resistance or the equivalent resistance is the sum of the individual resistances. See, R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now let me briefly talk about the main features of a series circuit. In a series circuit, the amount of current flow will be same all over the circuit. That means the current through this R1, R2 and R3 will be equal to I. Second one is that the total resistance RS will be equal to the sum of individual resistances. And third one is that the total power dissipated in this circuit is equal to the power dissipated in individual resistances. See, if I consider the power drop across this R1 as P1, power drop across this R2 is P2, power drop across this R3 is P3. Therefore, I can consider the total power P will be equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. Here our P1 will be equal to the current I square R1, P2 will be equal to I square R2, and P3 equal to I square R3. So I can write it like this: our P1 equal to I square R1. Our P2 will be equal to I square R2, and our P3 will be equal to I square R3, and our total power will be equal to I square into total resistance RS. Okay, so see, the total power that is absorbed by this circuit will be equal to the sum of the individual power drop across the resistor. Now let me show you an example of series circuit. For the following circuit, calculate the total current, voltage and power drop across each resistors. See, this 5 ohm, 10 ohm and 15 ohm resistors are connected in series across this 10 volt source. Therefore, if I, let's say, call this terminal as A and this terminal as B. See, as this is a total closed path, therefore I will expect a current flow from this positive terminal towards this negative terminal. That means our current will flow in this direction, and in a series circuit, current remains same throughout this path. Now we have to calculate the total current, voltage and power drop across each resistor. Total current, that means I have to calculate I. Voltage drop, let's say voltage drop across this 5 ohm is V1, across this 10 ohm is V2, and across this 15 ohm is V3. To calculate V1, I have to know the value of this I into the value of that resistor, I into 5. To calculate the value of V2, I have to know the value of current that is flowing through this 10 ohm, which is also equal to I into the value of that resistor. Simple Ohm's law, V equal to IR. To calculate V3, I have to know the value of current I that is flowing through this 15 ohm into 15, the value of resistor. Now what will be this current I? See, I is the total current in this circuit. Total current, that means the current that is supplied by the source in this circuit. To calculate the total current in a circuit, I have to use Ohm's law. I am calculating total current, therefore I will take total voltage applied in this circuit divided by total resistance of this circuit. Here I will denote this total voltage with V and the total resistance with RS or RT. You will see the RS, the resistance between this A and B terminal, will be equal to the, some of the resistors R1, R2 and R3 as they are connected in series. So our total resistance will be equal to 5 plus 10 plus 15, which will be equal to 30 ohm. Now, if I want to calculate total current, I will take total voltage 10 volt and total resistance equal to 30. That means I will get a current of 0.333 ampere. Now what will be the voltage drop across this resistor of 5 ohm? Just simple Ohm's law, I into R, 0.33 into 5. What will be the value of the voltage drop across this 10 ohm? Simply 0.33 into 10. What will be the value of V3 across this 15 ohm? 0.33 into 15. 0.33 into 15 will be equal to 5 volt. 0.33 into 10 will be equal to 3.33 volt. 0.33 into 5 will be equal to 1.67 volt. Now how do we calculate the power drop across each of the resistor? See, to calculate power P, I have to know the value of current that is flowing through the resistor, and I will take its square into the value of that resistor. Let's say the power that is absorbed by this 5 ohm is equal to P1, so I will get P1 equal to I square R1. Here I will be equal to 0.333 square and R1 is equal to 5. Therefore I will get P1 equal to 0.55 watt. This is how I can calculate our P2 equal to I square into this 10 ohm, and I can calculate P3 equal to I square into this 15 ohm. Okay, that's it. Thank you.